Hello there, welcome to this video where I'll be reacting to some of the new Pentatonix songs. So I've listened to You're Out, Petals and Midnight in Tokyo. Love them all, especially You're Out. And I've only got Anchor and Easy Love to listen to next. I couldn't record yesterday, so even though I was like so hungry to listen to the other songs, I waited till today. Let's get on with it, because I've been waiting too long. Let's start off with Easy Love. I think that's the chord progression for Watermelon Sugar and Blinding Lights. So chill, whoa. I don't know what that is in the background, but I love it. Nice. Very nice. That's like such a perfect song to fall asleep to, because it's just like relaxed, reverby. Oh yeah, that'd be a great song to fall asleep to for me, I think. Wow, I was not expecting that. I was expecting a bit more. Oh, I see. It's so relaxed and stuff because that's how easy the love is. Oh, whoa. Makes sense. Smart guys. See what the comments are saying. Oh, turned off. It's a chill song. I like it. Next one, Anchor. Oh, and then that's it. I thought there were three, but there's just two.
Every time that you tell me you want it, I can read your mind and I'm not even on it.
Sounds so good.
But you're always cutting me loose.
Chills. Damn. I love Mitch's part here. It sounds so good.
That'd
be so good to fall asleep to as well. Tonight's looking good. No, I love that. That's so, sounds so good. I love Mitch's part when he goes, Yeah, that is, I love that a lot, that like section of the song. Wow. Anchor, Easy Love, and Side. I feel like their kind of vibe is similar. Like it's just like chill, kind of reverbed out. I think, as I've said, those songs are like so good for sleeping to, I think. You can really see they're like trying new things, which is so, so sick to see. It's like they're documenting their exploration of music rather than, you know, creating a whole thing. Do you know what I mean? Like, it's like they're still just like having fun with it and experimenting, and it's so sick to see, like, even when they've made it, they're still, you know, trying new things and willing to risk kind of changing it up. I think that is so cool. Staying true to themselves, making the songs they feel like making at the time instead of what they think fans want from them. In music, that is, in any art, I think that's just so important. Even though you might prefer like some of their older songs and their, you know, their older style, that's fine, but you know, they're people, they change, and if they're making music, the music will change with them. So it's just super cool to see them evolve. Like when you look at their early stuff to then like their new stuff, it's, you can see it's really, it has changed quite a bit. It's not like crazy different to what they were doing when they first started, but you know, for a fan, like noticeably different. And it's just so cool to see that they're doing this. Even when they make it, they could just kind of sell out and release music like they know will do well with their fans, but trying new things. Yeah, just really awesome that they're doing that. I can't wait to see where they evolve. And I guess I was, in my last reaction video, I said, I guess they're gonna start releasing covers now. And then like the week after they were like, new music next week. So I guess that was completely wrong. So I'm not gonna try and guess what they're up to right now, but whatever it is, I'm looking forward to it. But yeah, I think that is it. I know I spoke more about like Pentatonix than those two specific songs, but I think you kind of have to with this new album and this new kind of like new Pentatonix era. Thank you guys for watching. Let me know what you guys thought in the comments about the whole album, and I'll see you later. Thank you. Goodbye.